welcome to Slumber Party Sunday. We're doing something a little different today. Instead of you listening to just me read, you're going to listen to my class read, How the Grinch Stole Christmas by Dr. Seuss.
Every town in Whoville liked Christmas a lot.
But the Grinch who lived just north of Whoville did not. The Grinch hated Christmas, the whole Christmas season. Please don't ask why. No one quite knows the reason.
It could be his head wasn't screwed on just right.
It could be, perhaps, that his shoes were too tight.
But I think that the most likely reason of all may have been that his heart was two sizes too small.
But whatever the reason was, his heart or his shoes, he stood there on Christmas Eve hating the Whos.
And they're hanging their stockings.
He snarled with a snail.
Tomorrow is Christmas. It's practically here.
And he growled with his Grinch fingers, nervously drumming.
I must find some way to stop Christmas from coming.
Tomorrow he knew.
All the Who girls and boys wake bright and early. They rush for their toys and then.
Oh, the noise.
That's one thing he hated.
The noise.
Noise.
Then the Who's young and old would sit down to a feast.
And they feast.
And they feast.
And they feast.
Feast.
They would feast on Who pudding and rare Who roast beast.
Which was something the Grinch couldn't stand in the least.
And then they'd do something he liked least of all.
Every Who down in Whoville, the Tot and his mom, was standing close together with Christmas bells ringing. They'd stand hand in hand.
And the Whos would start singing.
They'd sing.
And they'd sing.
And they'd sing.
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 And the more the Grinch thought of this Who's Christmas sing,
the more the Grinch thought.
I must stop this whole thing. Well, for 53 years I've put up with it now. I must stop Christmas from coming, but how?
Then he got an idea.
An awful idea.
The Grinch got a wonderful, awful idea.
I know just what I'll do. Great Grinchy trick. With this coat and this hat, I look just like Saint Nick. All I need is a reindeer.
Grinch looked around, but since reindeer were scarce, there was none to be found.
Did that stop the old Grinch?
No.
The Grinch simply said,
if I can't find a reindeer, I'll make one instead.
So he called his dog Max.
Then he took some red thread and he tied a big horn on top of his head. Then he loaded some bags and some old empty sacks on a ramble sack sled.
And he hitched up on them. Then the Grinch said,
giddy up!
And they slid, and the sleigh started down towards the home where the Who's lay asleep in the town.
All their windows were dark, white snow filled the air.
All the Who's were all dreaming sweet dreams without care.
When he came to his first little house on the square.
This is stop number one.
The old Grinch, he uncrossed his.
And he climbed to the roof, empty bags in his fist.
Then he slid down the chimney around a tight pinch.
But Santa could do it.
And so could the Grinch.
He got stuck only once for a moment or two.
Then he stuck his head out the fireplace flue. And the little Who stockings all hung in a row.
The stockings.
He
grinned, are the first things to go.
Then he slithered and slunk with a small muscle plan.
Around the whole room, he took every present.
Pop guns.
And bicycles.
Roller skates.
Drums.
Checkerboards.
Tricycles.
Popcorn.
And plums.
And he stuffed them in bags.
Then the Grinch very normally stuffed all the bags one by one up the chimney.
Then he slunk into the icebox.
He took the Who's feast.
He took the Who's pudding.
He took the roast feast.
He cleaned out the icebox and skipped as a flash.
Why that Grinch even took their last can of food hash.
Then he stuffed all the food up the chimney.
And now?
Grinch the Grinch.
I will stuff up the tree.
And the Grinch grabbed the tree and started to shove.
When he heard a small sound like a coo of a dove,
he turned around fast and he saw a small who.
Cindy Lou Who.
Who was not more than two.
The Grinch had been caught by this tiny who daughter who got out of the bed for a cup of cold water.
Stared after Grinch and said, why are you taking our Christmas tree? Why?
But you know that old Grinch was so smart and so slick, he thought up a lie.
He thought it a quip.
Why, my sweet little tot?
He makes Santa Claus lie.
There's a light on this tree that won't light on one side, so I'm taking it home to my workshop, my dear. I'll fix it up there, then I'll bring it back here.
And his bed for the child.
Then he patted her head and he got her a drink and he sent her to bed.
And when Cindy Lou Who went to bed with her cup, he went up the chimney and stuffed up the tree.
Then the last thing he took was a log for the fire.
Then he went up the chimney himself, the old liar.
On their walls, he left nothing but hooks and some wire.
And the one speck of food that he left in the house was a crumb that was even too small for a mouse.
But he did the same thing to the other Who's houses,
leaving crumbs too small for the other Who's mouses.
It was a quarter past dawn.
Although he's still dead.
And all of his shoes are still on shoes.
We packed up his sled.
Packed it up with their presents.
The ribbons.
The wrappings.
The tag.
And the tinsel.
The trimmings.
The trappings.
Three thousand feet up.
Of the side of the mountain trumpet.
He rode with his load to tick-tock to dump it.
Hoo-hoo to the Who's.
He was great to be coming.
They're finding out now that Christmas is, that no Christmas is coming. They're just waking up. I know just what they'll do. Their mouths will hang open for a minute or two, and then the Who's in Whoville will all cry boo-hoo. What a noise that I simply must hear.
So he paused, and the Grinch put his hand to his ear, and he did hear the sound rising over the snow.
It started in low.
Then it started to grow.
But the sound wasn't sad.
Why, this sound merry?
It couldn't be so.
But it was merry.
Very!
He stared down at Hoo.
The Grinch popped his eyes.
Then he shook.
What he saw was a shocking surprise.
Everyone being down in Whoville, tall and small, was singing.
Without any presents at all.
He hadn't stopped Christmas from coming. It came.
Somehow or other, it came just the same.
And the Grinch, with his foot feet ice cold in the snow,
stood puzzling and puzzling.
How could it be so? It came without ribbons. It came without tags. It came without...
and the Grinch thought of something he hadn't before.
Maybe Christmas,
he thought,
doesn't come from a store. Maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more.
And what happened then?
Well, in Whoville, they say that the Grinch's small heart was inside of that ball.
And the minute his heart didn't feel quite so tight, he whisked through with his love glowing bright white.
And he brought back the toys
and the food for the feast.
And